She's still killing. Those are human organs, right? Nah, everything that is happening now is the past. And I like how they are going back in the past to kind of give us a rundown what started all of this. And it helps to build this character named Trese. Because all this happened in the past, right? What is going on right now? Ooh, they broke his arm. In Filipino. They are summoning something. It's some strange. Those kids don't go down, huh? What are they made out of? This is some sick ritual. He's gonna attack his own kids? What the is it? Those two twins, I feel like they are the two guards protecting Tracy now. It seems like this was the bad guy her father Antonio dealt with during his time. And if you're wondering what I'm drinking juice, by the way. You should have just get in her car and drive. Get underneath the car. Jeez. Someone needs to put a cap on these monsters, man. They are acting wild and reckless. I'm telling you, it must be those two twins over there when they were young. So that was their father. The wife goes through all these problems, all these trials. Resurrecting his podcast, and he comes out and he is looking into eating his own children. That's messed up. There is something about this anime that also reminds me of Death Note. She should use her that hocus pocus eyeball thing that she does. But I don't think that woman even saw who attacked her because her face was facing forward, right? This woman knows everyone. Like, she is not lacking in. So that dagger can also attack ghosts, not just monsters. They just have to keep quiet and let him finish with his chit chatting. He's spraying that thing in literally in his face. She saw something. That's the same red eye that killed that woman, right? Okay. Is that Nuno? Nuno. Each time Nuno finishes, whenever Nuno is done giving the intel, he skedaddles. All right. I'm getting ready. Oh, is he get? This thing doesn't play fair. This thing doesn't play fair at all. And it seems like it doesn't like light, being in the light. There it is, Musiketa. You think you know what he wants? Damn. She stabbed that little monster until the knife, the dagger, broke. And that creature came from her, came out of her. He runs away. The fire came and just consumed it. Oh. Oh, damn. She's in for it now. She got killed. Ooh, so that's how Trese's dad met his end. Oh, she had to finish the ritual. So this is Guerrero's everyday life before getting to work. Yeah, we are all assholes here. I said this earlier that the monsters are no longer concerned. They're no longer concerned about the consequences for what they do now. They are no longer scared. That big boss did say that something is coming, and when it comes, that Trese should not look to his tribe for help. All of them. Oh, it's somebody else. Rude. Oh boy. They are in for it right now. The police department are in for it. If you don't tell me what is going on. Damn. Oh man. They need to barricade the whole area. And these zombies are not. But it seems like there is a spell that was used to summon them. Ooh, a blooder. Dragon blood. Watch. Oh. That is close, because if that zombie had bit him, it's over. It's literally over. Even till now, anything can happen to. Check before you open the door, you oaf. Oh. This zombie is desperate. Finally, he acts. Oh, these zombies can run. Oh. There are out of bullets. Thank goodness for great, is it Gray Santorino? He knows their name. Raul Lazaro. Wow, just like that. I'm not sure if they can be able to react in time to save themselves. Oh boy. Well, there you have it, episode 3 and 4, guys. I'm not sure if those two are going to survive. I think the weird-looking old geezer might be able, just for the fact that he has super unnatural power to him, that he can literally disappear through the ground. But I'm not sure about the other human, if he's going to survive this. Let's see what's going to happen on the final two episodes. So don't go too far.